Hello, ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen back there, gentlemen, don't see the LA like. Welcome to Batman Arkham Asylum. It's been a while since I've done one of these intro things for one of my videos. Because, oh boy, do I just keep going and going. I'm having fun playing this game, as you can tell, so, you know. Sorry if you don't hear me talking that as much as I usually do. So, let's get started with this episode of Batman, shall we? We're in another one of those nightmare sequences, because in the last part we literally started coughing. And as you can see, we're having rain indoors. Huh. Like I said before, Batman apparently during these weird nightmare sequences seems to move around directly without too much input from the player. It's like, oh hey, he moves around because of different people. No, he moves around because of other stuff. It's like, he moves around during these whole things, so it makes sense why this is the case. And we're on a Dutch angle again. God damn it. And if I'm not mistaken, I think those are dollar bills, right? I think. Oh no, wait, those are pictures. Photographs of... Oh, those are photographs of Batman's parents. Lovely. Ah, great. Now the things are moving. Can't access my weapons now.
I can't believe you insisted on sitting through that movie again, Bruce. Come on. We'll be late for Alfred.
I'm sorry, Daddy.
Ah, great. The background's starting to go away from me.
He loved it so. Alfred will wait. Keep up, Bruce.
I do want to talk about Alfred eventually, but I'll get to him later. Maybe as soon as we get to a bio. Maybe later. And look, now we have trash cans? Okay. And they're starting to become wooden boards on the sides of these buildings.
Where are you taking us?
We can cut through here.
But it's starting to rain. Bruce is tired. Can't we just wait for him here?
Come on, keep up. We're nearly there.
I think it's supposed to become an alleyway. Well, actually, I know it's supposed to become an alleyway, but I'm just trying to lead up to that. And I think these are newspapers, right? Or supposed to be newspaper stacks? At least I believe so. Oh god, this Dutch angle is gonna kill me. Yep, now we're in an alleyway.
Please, there's no need for this.
Stay where you are.
I'll give you whatever you want.
Tom! Oh god, Tom!
Be quiet, lady. Just shut up.
Don't give up, Bruce.
Come on, kid, this way. Take a seat in my office.
Is he okay?
He'll be fine. Kid like that with all that money, he'll be just fine.
Shut up, now. He's 8 years old and all alone. Money won't fix that.
Whatever you say, Gordon. His butler's on his way to pick him up. You hear that? He's got a butler.
I'm sorry about that. I just need to ask you some questions. Can I get you anything? You okay? I know you don't feel like answering me, but it's the only way to catch who did this. Something wrong with it. And listen, son, call me Jim.
This was what I was talking about. Like, we don't really get an origin story for Batman here, but we get enough of a, like, his actual backstory here that makes you feel like Batman enough to where you'd be like, well, now I understand what he is trying to do at least. And it certainly does actually give a connection between, like, Batman and Jim, or Gordon here, because it's like, why would Batman respect the guy, or the police commissioner chief, exactly? Shouldn't he be against it since he's a vigilante? But no, he respects him, and actually has a bit of a connection with him. So, I think that's pretty cool, that they actually showcase this here. I will talk more about Alfred, because I really like him, and his connection to Batman, everything else, but I'll get to him when we get to him. For now, let's actually get through this hellish platforming, because that's what we're going to be doing, ladies and gentlemen. Some hellish nightmare platforming, everyone. Can I hit you with the... Oh, no. I was hoping to hit a batarang at his fingertips.
Stay still.
Dang it!
Won't hurt. And at the end of fear, oblivion.
Yeah, sure. Go yourself. I'm surprised he doesn't look at that and say, that seems suspicious. No, apparently he's just like, nah, it's all right. Dang it. Kind of hoping just to get through that really quickly. I blame myself for that one because I was being hubris. Like, literally, I was just trying to go through this one shot, one opportunity, really quickly. But I need to remember, this is not how it works. You're supposed to take this somewhat slow. Well, slow as it can be for this type of, sort of, like, environmental thing.
I'll get you now.
Really? 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 Come on. Give it a second. And give it a second. There we go. Okay, this time I'll wait. Oh, I almost got... Oh, man. I got cut up on the side because it was like... It wasn't completely in line with me, so I was behind it. So, oh, God. That was way too close. You heard nothing. But, this is another thing that apparently... That this is, literally a thing that happens. Real quick to explain... I think these are supposed to be, like, literally the guard, the enemies, but for some reason they're now skeleton enemy things. They don't really take much to take down, they're just a little bit annoying to deal with. But yeah, you have to defeat them in order to get past them, so, you know, there you go. They're not too bad, it's a little bit weird that they're skeletons, and that's it, really. I expected them to maybe be, like, Joker or something, but I'm guessing they're saving that for Arkham Knight. Or maybe it was, what was it? Or maybe it's City that has that, I forget. I know Arkham Knight doesn't have any more of those. Like, Nightmare-esque sequences? I don't think Arkham Origins has one of those either. All I do know is that Arkham City does have somewhat similar things like this, but it's more like a combat challenge sort of thing that isn't really, you know.
I will break you.
But it isn't really much of like, you know, like an actual, like, you know, platforming challenge like this. It's more of like, what do you call it? Like a combat arena sort of thing. It actually involves
everything you see is under my control.
It's actually like control, like the thing I'm talking about, the combat challenge thing, arena thing I'm talking about. It's actually controlled by the Mad Hatter villain I was talking about before, like the Alice in Wonderland character that Batman faces. And no, it's not the actual Mad Hatter from Alice in Wonderland. It's just a person taking up the name of, you know, so yeah, anytime you get an 8-1, you just press A and X, and it'll just automatically take someone down or grab throw them. So that's interesting. Maybe I should have gotten the auto damage thing. What's it called? The auto takedown. Maybe I should have gotten that one instead. Well, thanks. I thought I actually made that, but no, I was stupid. Wait for it. Go! Okay, good. Whew!
There's no escape.
That's what you think, pal. Woo! Just double checking. Woo!
Your mind will shatter like glass.
Oh. The whole, like, thing was coming towards me slowly actually scared me a bit. I was like, oh, my heart almost stopped there for a second thinking about, like, oh, no, I have to do the whole thing over if I screw this up. Come on, go. Use it! Shouldn't he go like, no! Well, maybe I stopped him before he could do that, thankfully. Well, that was it. Thank God.
Has anyone seen the bat? Come on! Someone must have seen where it went. Big scary man. Where's the cape? Jumped out of the shadows and beats up useless bugs. Anyone?
Zaz has Dr. Young trapped in the warden's office. I've got to get out of here.
That's really weird how he just ended up here somehow. I'm being serious when I say somehow Batman ended up here in the clock bell tower somehow. Like, literally, there's no other way I can see how he got up except maybe through this little, like through the here?
I need to find another way down.
Seriously, how did you open this if it was locked? Like, how'd you break through it, lock it behind you, and then immediately just ended up here? Because, like, this is the only way down I can actually figure out, and hopefully no one is down below for this. Well, then. Like I said, at least no one was down there when this was dropped, right? Hopefully. I think. Okay, just checking. I was like wondering. I knew, like, one of these things were up here. But yeah, real quick, we kind of needed to do that. No other way around here, really. So, how much collateral damage do you think this will cost Wayne Industries? Because I feel as if it'll cost a lot. Oh, man. Hoo boy. Oh, yeah, I forgot to get this. I could have sworn I did get it. Or I didn't think it was here. Well, whatever.
Patient interview 6. Dr. Crane has been back in custody for...
Nah, I'm not going to listen to Scarecrow's ones. They're kind of self-explanatory and simple. The difference is, though, we learn more about, like, Killer Croc through his interview tapes better. Crane's is just more character, yeah, but we are being introduced to him decently enough, I think. And, the thing about, like, the one I'm letting listen, I think, like, the ones that actually introduce more character, like Ivy's, maybe we'll get some exceptions. But things like Dr. Young / Joker's interview tapes, I'm allowing not to be played because it's like, well, they reveal more about the character / more about the story through that way. So I'm not letting them play out until later. So, you know, at least there's that. Hmm. So yeah, in order to deal with those stun baton enemies, just jump over them.
Oh, there you are. I've been waiting for you, listening to Zaz make the good doctor scream while you played around in Scarecrow's world. How was it this time? Learn anything about yourself? Oh, tell me. Pull up a seat. Talk to me. I'm all ears. Actually, that reminds me. I could have sworn I heard Zaz cutting her ears off. Certainly sounded like it.
Okay, I knew, like, Catwoman, or, yeah, Catwoman's, goggles were here somewhere. I just didn't know where. Because, like, they're in a case like, you know, the Penguin, so I thought... Like, oh, are they near penguins? No, they're in this area. Okay. I'm just, like, double-checking to make sure. Some of the Arkham TVs he has somewhat have, you know, his new logo on them. Some of them don't. I'm not sure whether or not he programs that or whether or not that's just a small little detail he sometimes does himself.
Stay where you are, Batman.
Listen to me carefully.
Help me!
Come any closer, I'll paint the room crimson with her blood. I know you're out there.
I can see the veins in her neck throbbing. I can smell her sweat and tears.
Yeah, how about you shut up?
You monster! You evil, evil, evil monster!
He's not going anywhere. You can stop now.
How about you actually incapacitate him and put him in cuffs or something, Batman? Seriously?
I saw Bane.
To stop the experiment.
I feel bad for her to a degree, but unfortunately she doesn't have much of a redemption arc to really successfully prove anything. You'll see what I mean in a second, unfortunately.
So now he has venom and your formula.
God, he has gallons of the stuff. There's a lab hidden in the gardens. It's locked off, but the security key codes for the entire island are in the warden's safe.
What else is Joker planning?
How should I know? You think anything he says makes sense? I think he's insane. Oh my god!
Get out of the way!
Why didn't you use your bat claw on her and pull her? You can pull it on enemies. And she's dead, by the way.
Talking about squealers.
Oh,
Yeah, well, you won't get the chance. First, deal with this guy. But yeah.
Oracle, Dr. Young is dead. Have you figured out a way past these security gates? Before she died, she told me there's a production plant hidden somewhere in the gardens.
The Wayne Tech security protocols seem to be hackproof. Lucius did a good job. It's a two-part biometric sequence, apparently generated by the Warden, using a code sequencer.
And destroyed by Joker in the safe explosion. Harley Quinn has the Warden, and he's the only chance we have to get past these gates.
Okay.
So that was kind of bad for her. Oh well. I really do feel bad for her. It's like, oh yeah, she was like a Batman villain character who just exists. It's like, oh yeah, it's definitely like, you know, a person who, she tried to do something bad, but you know, she tried to, you know, slightly redeem herself, and then, bam, she's dead. Certainly one of the quickest deaths I've ever seen in a video game. At least for a character introduced in a game. So unfortunately for us, Dr. Young is dead. And that went from 0 to 100 kind of quick. Like, it's like, oh, we saved her, now she's dead. Man, that's really disappointing. I'm guessing in the confusion, Zaz decided to leave. Oh well. And by the way, yes, I actually wanted to do, I knew about this little room because it's not mentioned in any regards anywhere else, but you only ever see this once. Well, somewhat once. You can usually discover this room by itself somewhere, but this is it, really. This is a secret room that talks about something. Take a look at this. City Patrol. Steel plant. Gotham City, Arkham approved. What is he planning to do exactly? Arkham Asylum, City Gates. Seems interesting. This is the Warden's secret room of sorts. It's a little area in which it's just his secret stuff that just talks about something. Seems to involve around Gotham, a part of Gotham City, and also, you know, in and of itself, something to do with Arkham. Huh, I wonder what it could mean. Well, I know what it means, but I won't comment on it until way later. And I just wanted to showcase that because I've always seen it, never really actually opened it myself, and wondered whether or not I was dreaming it or not. Like, is that how you do it? No, it's something else. Poor Dr. Young. Let's see, what is this? Is he bleeding? I think, right? Yeah, it's blood. What's that smell? It's blood! Okay, as soon as we get to another save point, maybe as soon as I exit the mansion, I'll immediately stop. Mainly because it's like, I kind of don't need to do anything else other than stop right now because I need to edit some of my videos so that way they're, you know. So they're at least a little bit edited down so that way I can at least, you know, record more.
Shut it. Now. You heard that, right?
Yeah, you know where to find me. Later.
Kind of surprised I was able to take all three of them down that quickly. Like, I was literally kind of worried there for a minute. Okay, just checking. I was like thinking like, oh god, like Ghost Warner was like, oh no, oh no, like I was thinking like, oh, does this thing still work? Yeah, it does actually. Okay, now I need to go outside. Maybe, in a bit, but first, just in case, I'm gonna exit out through the top of the building. Because I know for a fact, if I exit through the bottom, it could end up terribly for me. But for now, I'm just going to basically just leave it right here. Because I need to edit my other videos, because, you know, to save up on space. So, anyway guys, if you enjoyed this video of Arkham Asylum, I hope you enjoy the series. Sorry if I'm not, like, ending off the episodes as I usually do. But it's, you know, I'm trying to, like, go through this as quickly as I can, slash, as much as I want to. And then I'm trying to edit the videos as best I can. So, anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. And I'll see you next time for the next video of Batman Arkham Asylum. Until then, sayonara, my bots. Take care.